Nathan Outlaw has made his mark showcasing fish from the Cornish coast with his simple, honest approach. His incredible skill and palate has led to 2 Michelin stars for his restaurant, Nathan Outlaw. The first time this accolade has ever been awarded to a seafood restaurant in Britain. It has also topped the UK Best Restaurant list for 2 years running, making this humble chef one of the stars of his generation.
It was really hard to pick 4 of my best dishes because I've cooked so many dishes and been cooking for over 20 years. But these 4 really showcase what I'm all about. Point for me where I started really realizing what I was about as a chef was when I went to work for Rick Stein down in Padstow at the seafood restaurant. And this was sort of like the mid to late 90s. So at that point, the seafood restaurant was huge. You know, everyone was talking about Rick Stein. I didn't really enjoy eating fish until I started working for Rick Stein. You know, fish fingers were probably as far as it went when I was younger, and then fish and chips was a treat. But seeing all this beautiful, simple seafood just blew my mind. And I think you have to eat them. If you don't, you're mugging yourself off. So I just went in there with an open mind and just engulfed myself in it and, you know, learned everything I could. There's no question for me that when I was asked about my greatest dishes ever, fish and chips had to be on it. So there's lots of different fish that work well with fish and chips. But for me, one at the moment that's really, really good is hake. It's nice, white, flaky fish. It's got lots of flavour. You can go really, really sort of technical with batter. I found this one to be the perfect batter for fish and chips. And what it is a self-raising flour and then some sparkling cider. I think the cider is a really nice acidity coming in. Still to this day, Rick's enthusiasm about cooking, especially when he travels around the world, when you work in that environment, you can't not be inspired. What you're looking for is a sort of coats the whisk. A little bit of salt and pepper. And that's it, batter done. I met my wife, Rachel, working at the seafood restaurant with Rick Stein. It wasn't the usual sort of flirtatious chatting up, you know, over the hot plate thing. She told me when I asked her to make me a cup of coffee to get it in my flipping self. The flipping was a bit more extreme than flipping, that's all I say. But, and I thought, yeah, like she's spicy, I like that one. Fish and chips isn't complete without the king of the condiments, tartar sauce. So to make your own mayonnaise, you need some egg yolks, a little bit of English mustard, because it's got a bit of a kick to it, and you've got some white wine vinegar. So you've got some olive oil here, some light olive oil. If you put in extra virgin olive oil in it, it'd be too strong at the end. So I just want a pretty neutral flavour. Slowly at first, add a few drops of oil. If you add too much oil at once, it's just gonna split. I actually use mayonnaise quite a lot in my restaurants, and a lot of my chef friends wind me up a little bit about it because they say there's always mayonnaise on my menus. But it's lovely, isn't it? So you're looking for a nice mayonnaise that's nice and thick. We've been together since we were 18 and 19 years old. We've been married for 17 years now. She's from Padstow, proper Cornish girl, and is one of the reasons why I'm still in Cornwall. So tartar sauce, you have to have lots of herbs. So I've got some chopped tarragon, parsley, chives, some chopped gherkin, and I've got some chopped capers as well. All flavours that work really, really well with fish. And that's it, that's the tartar sauce done. And ready for the fish and chips. So these potatoes have been parboiled. It's important that you cook until they're soft because otherwise, when you put them into the fryer when they're raw, you'll just end up with quite a soggy chip. A piece of fish is 3 or 4 minutes, but chips sometimes can take up to 8 or 9 minutes in the fryer and they jam up the system. So I've had more tellings off about my chips coming to the hot plate than anything else, I think, in my career. I'm now going to batter my fish and cook that, and then these will go back in again. I think for me, as a chef, seafood, the reason why I love it so much is because it's a challenge. It's never, ever the same twice. You know, because things come into play like the weather, you know, the seasonality of the fish. So she's going to lightly dust the cake with some flour. What that does is it makes the batter stick to it. I think that, combined with my respect for the sea and for fishermen, makes me want to do it, yeah, and be part of that world. So you just hold the fish for a few seconds in the fryer. That's just really to set the batter so it doesn't stick to the basket. The batter is the perfect vehicle to cook a piece of fish in. It surrounds a perfect succulent piece of fish and keeps it steamed inside, and there's no better way to cook fish. So once the fish is almost there, I'm going to put the chips back into there to just give them their final fry. OK, so we've got some crushed mushy peas, the tartar sauce, some lovely chips, and a beautiful piece of fish. Fish and chips, the best fish dish in the world. Mmm, so good. I've been cooking seafood exclusively now for 10 years, and even with a 2 Michelin star seafood restaurant, I still think this dish is the best seafood dish you can have.